Form Architects has been around for 4.5 years. During this time, we've done a number of projects. We actually specialize in commercial and residential architecture, and we also do interiors. I want to start off by showing you some of the work that we have done and also some of the work we're doing now. And then we'll show you this new project we've been working on for a while because we're making it public for the first time. I want to talk to you about the technology. Most persons, when they think about an architect, they're thinking that we're actually drawing, or we're drawing lines on a paper, we're producing blueprints and so on. We're actually not doing that anymore. Well, I'm not. In the 1960s, everyone basically drew by hand. And so you see these people with pencils and they're drawing on these drawing tables and so on. And that changed in the 1970s when they actually introduced what you call CAD, computer-aided design or drawing. And so everybody has, you all heard about AutoCAD? Right. So everybody's using AutoCAD. Now in the 80s, they turned AutoCAD just from those digital lines now to a three-dimensional interface. So you could have three-dimensional objects and so on. And in the 90s, a new thing was born, which is called building information modeling. Now, building information modeling is the foundations of what we do, but we've expanded it so much that we're now at what you call 6D. Now, everybody knows 2D, 3D. It actually goes to 7. Now, 3D, or BIM, you are creating a virtual replica of the building in a virtual environment. So exactly how it's being built, that's how we're building it in a virtual space. Now, what it means is that you can add all your materials, you can add your lighting, you can add all these different things to give your clients a more realistic representation of what they're going to get. Now, we've taken it further, and we've now created what is called 4D. Now, 4D is adding time to it, meaning that when you create something, it's now producing now a schedule for its delivery, meaning it breaks it down in terms of the tasks, the time it takes, so someone can actually begin to construct the building. Now, we've pushed it further again, and we've taken it to what is called 5D. And 5D is when you're adding cost to it, which is very, very important, because sometimes in our field, you generally have what is called a quantitative surveyor who actually costs your building after you design it. This now, we have now removed that process in terms of making it all integrated. So instantaneously, you can know when we design something, you have the cost immediately. And I'm quite possibly the only person in the Caribbean who can actually do that at the moment. So BIM, the concept. What it means is that we're building, as I said, a virtual model, and everything that we produce as an architect comes from this virtual model. So all the drawings that you see, all the blueprints, all this stuff just is automatic from this virtual model and is linked together. So when you make a change to one thing, everything else changes. Now, what that has allowed us to do is we have doubled our output and reduced our time for production by at least 30%. And that's a significant for an architecture company. A building or a house is comprised of thousands of parts. And so therefore, and they're all interchangeable. And they are one affects the other. So what it means is that we have a greater handle on what we are producing as architects and how it will affect, one, the landscape, and also giving people what they want. With all this technology, we thought to ourselves, what can we do with this? And how can we make a significant change to homes? We all want homes. We all live somewhere, and we all generally want to own where we live. So how could we actually use this technology to influence the building of homes in Jamaica, and how can we make it more cost effective? And we came up with what I'm about to show you. Thank you.
cloud. You are the end and the beginning. A world where time is not allowed. There's no such thing as competition. To find a way we'll lose control. Remember laws of no limitation. This is a journey of the soul.
We're trying to create is a marketplace for building homes, and we have a very different approach. Now, what we want to do is to connect every single person who is involved in the process of making a home. Why? Think about it. Most persons don't even know where to begin in building a home. Most persons don't want to go through the hassle of building a home when really and truly they could customize something for themselves, but they'd rather go and buy something when they could actually build a house probably twice the size for half the cost or for the same cost. Now, there are particular problems in that persons don't know who to go to as an architect. They don't know who to go to in terms of a contractor or who to trust. A lot of people lose their money because they risk their life savings with somebody who they don't even know or have no contractual obligation to. And so we want to diminish that and give persons a different alternative. So having showed you all this technology, this is now how we're going to use it. We've built a virtual space, a virtual website, to actually provide you pre-designed homes, which now cost a fraction of what it would normally cost in terms of affording an architect. Because we're using a virtual construction model, what it means is that we can produce one, this house, at a cheaper cost in terms of design, and we can also give you so much more than an ordinary architectural firm, and we can also now, which is our hope, to link you with all the people who are going to be in the process of making this home. So what you can actually do is you'd go on and you would sign up, and you have different kinds of memberships. You have homeowners, or home builders, we call them, and they can actually go in and search for the plans that they want. They can go to the resources, find a builder, and so on, or they can actually just put in finding this plan, they can actually put in the parameters of what they want. So for instance, you wanted a two-bedroom, with two bathrooms, and we see the options that come up. Now, it's in the beginning stages, and we're starting off with 40 houses. By Christmas, we should probably be about 100. Now, it's also built open so that other architects, other designers can actually input their designs into this platform and sell their designs. So, if you think about it, it's almost like we're kind of creating a Facebook for homes.